Now, for our company call segment this morning, we are joined by the President and CEO of Trans Asia Oil and Development Corporation, Dr. Francisco Viray. Good morning, Dr. Viray.
Good morning, Maiki.
Thank you for being here this morning.
My pleasure.
Okay, Dr. Viray, you're in the high-risk and capital-intensive business of oil and gas exploration and development. But apart from that, you're also into power generation and electricity supply. Where do the bulk of your revenues come from?
Bulk of revenue right now comes from the power business.
Okay.
They are mostly recurring.
Okay. When you say the bulk, how much?
Almost 100%.
Almost 100%. Yeah. And this is because at this time you have no producing oil well.
Yes.
However, you have four service contracts in oil and gas, right?
That's correct.
You have SC-51 in Leyte, SC-69 in between Bohol and Cebu.
Yes.
SC-55 in Palawan. And SC-6. In Palawan as well.
That's correct.
How close are you to finding oil in these areas?
Well, hard to say, but I guess for SC-51, our partner yesterday made a disclosure that they will be drilling Duhat 2 within this month.
Okay.
So that's the closest to, as far as the work program is concerned, that's the closest part of the work program wherein you want to find oil.
All right, so that's SC-51 in Leyte.
Yes.
And when you say close, how close is close?
Well, if we drill hole and then we find oil, then
it could
that's
be
it.
Immediate.
Yes.
It could be immediate.
If we find oil.
All right.
But even if you strike oil, you still have to determine whether it is of commercial quantity or not.
And
it still has to go through a process.
It's a part of a very lengthy process.
Yes,
even
that's
before
correct.
You can begin drilling, it takes about three, four, five years?
3 to 5 years.
Okay. All right. In any case, the first half of the year was very good for you guys.
Yes, we were up 300% year on year.
300%. Mm. And this was because of higher sales?
Higher sales, new market.
Okay.
We currently have two cement companies and one electric cooperative and one export processing zone as customers.
Okay, through a triple digit advance, 300%. How are things shaping up for the second quarter? Will sales be as robust?
First half, we believe that we can do better than last year's first half.
Okay, better but not as great as the first quarter.
First quarter, yes.
Okay, all right, that's close enough because I know you can't give exact figures. You released a disclosure the other day saying that a joint venture firm between you and AC Energy, South Luzon Thermal Energy Corp, will receive a 7 billion peso loan to expand its Calaca thermal power plant from 135 to 270 megawatts. The target completion date for this is first quarter 2016.
We can be earlier and can shoot for last quarter of 2015.
Okay. Now, another big development for you guys was the declaration of commerciality for your wind project.
Yes, that's correct. That's our wind project in Guimaras. It's 54 megawatt. And we're about to start construction.
Okay. Now, how much is this expected to contribute to your bottom line?
Well, in terms for the wind project and for the second unit of SLTEC, that would be substantial, considering that if you look at our portfolio, that would probably increase by our capacity by 100%.
Okay. Any other updates from TransAsia that you'd like to share with us?
Well, as far as the power business is concerned, the implementation of the retail and open access has started, and we expect to contribute further to our bottom line.
Okay. Can you give us a target for the full year 2013?
Well, we're hoping for a better performance than last year.
Okay. Can you give us percentage-wise how much better? Any indication?
Well, I think it's hard to...
Okay, hard to give a figure, but you're optimistic.
But it's better than,
optimistic.
It would be better than last year.
All right, we'll leave it at that. Thank you for your time this morning, Dr. Viray.
Thanks, Maiki, also.